Today I wanted to show you how to play a song that I heard so much when I was growing up. I don't know how many people are familiar with this song, but it's a song by Chris Isaak called I Wonder. And I first heard this song on a movie called Tin Cup. It's that golf movie with Kevin Costner. And when I was growing up in the 90s, my dad was always trying to be a professional golfer qualifying for the PGA Senior Tour. And Tin Cup was one of his favorite movies. He had the soundtrack on CD. And anytime I was in the car with him, he would always be playing that soundtrack, and I would hear this song over and over again. I would also hear that song, A Little Bit Is Better Than Nada. Sometimes You Want the Whole Enchilada. I forget the name of it or who sings it, but there's a lot of cool songs on that record. And this is a song that's always meant a lot to me. It's a song that I'm sure all of us can relate to at some point. Great lyrics, great tone. So the whole song is basically just going to be a 1-4-5 in C major, but we're going to be outlining those chords with triads, and we'll get into the solo, and it's really just going to be about touch and tone and the feel in which you play all these different kind of lead lines with. All right, so we're going to start out with this intro. Throughout the song, there's two guitar parts going on. You have an acoustic guitar that's just strumming the basic chords real low in the mix, and then you have the electric guitar that's doing all the fills and lead lines and everything, right? So we'll just start out with the intro. It's just going to be C major to G7. And you just kind of take your index finger on and off the high E string. But that's all the intro is doing for like the first 16 measures, right? All right, so that's all you're going to be doing, just C major, 3-2-0-1 to your G7, 3-2-0-0-0-1. And then just take your index finger off of that first fret and back to C major, right? Okay, and so then the verse rhythm part is just going to be C major, F major, G major, back to C major. Okay, and don't play in the fills unless you're playing this by yourself, you know, just leave all that stuff out. So you just keep playing. All right, and then when we switch, we get into the pre-chorus. We're just going to go A minor, G major, to C major. Okay, repeat that. All right, do it the third time. And then after you play A minor, G, C the third time, then go to F major, after you go to that C. And then if you go to F, go to G. Now I wonder. And then we go back in to the same thing we were doing in the intro, that C to G7. Alright, so that's the whole rhythm part for the entire song, right? That's all you need. And then all the cool stuff that's happening is all the little lead things. Alright, so we'll just go through the rhythm part real quick. We'll go through the intro, a verse, and a pre-chorus, and then we'll get into all the lead stuff, alright? So that's the whole rhythm part for the entire song. It just keeps doing that same thing where it goes through your verse, your pre-chorus, and then back to the intro for like 16 bars, and then just keeps looping that over and over throughout the song, right? And so the lead part, let's get into that because that's really where all the cool stuff is, right? So in the intro, you have, you're just going to form C major chord, 3rd fret A string, 2nd fret D string, open G, 1st fret on the B string. Hit the open D string twice, second time hammer on to the 2nd fret on D, and after you hammer on to the 2nd fret on D, let it ring out and then hit the G string. Okay, then you're going to go up to the 7th fret on the G string, going to bend up a whole step. You kind of do a real gradual bend up and down. Okay, and then after you bring that bend down, you're going to slide in from 5 to 7, back to 5. Alright. And then we're going to bend 5 on the D string. Okay, just bend that up a whole step and bring it back down. You can bend it down if you wanted to. Whatever you feel comfortable doing, right? So that'll be that intro part. Okay, and then what we're gonna do during the verse for the lead part, he's basically just doing these kind of downward strums on each chord, letting that tremolo ring, right? C, F, G. And after you get to that C, do that little fill again where you just hold down a C major chord, hit open D, then hammer on the D on 2, and then hit the open G, let them ring together. Then we're going to hit 1 on B. And after you hit 1 on B, hit 2 on G with your middle finger, and hit open G, and let the G and B ring out the whole time, right? Then we're gonna hit the open D. And after you hit that open D, go right back to your C major chord, 3-2-0-1. All right, he kind of varies when he does that throughout the song, right? But that'll be your first part, okay? Same strums again. Then before we get into the pre-chorus, we'll change it. You hit that open D, hammer on to 2 on D, get your open G. Then we're going to do the same rhythm, but we're going to play the open G, and then hit it twice. Second time, hammer on to 2 on G, and then hit 1 on the B string. after you do that, we're going to start walking down these triads. We're going to play A minor, G major, C major. Okay, and we're just going to do that triad instead. We're going to go A minor, G major, C major. And do that little lick in between, right? So we're just going to have 9 on the G string, 10 on the B string, and 8 on the high E string. Now sometimes I think he may play some of these like as double stop, like dyads on the G and B string, you know, doing like, you can kind of mess around with that and play it different ways. I think it sounds better playing it like this with the high E string. Just sounds more full, kind of rings out better, but you know, what do I know? So you have your A minor triad, 9, 10, 8. Then your G major triad, you'll have 7 on G, 8 on B, 7 on E. And then walk down to your C major triad, 5 on G and B, and 3 on the high E. Okay, so you'll have... Okay, then have your middle finger here on 5 on G. Slide up from 5 to 9 on G, and then hit 8 on the B string. And it's kind of a gradual slide, where you kind of slide slowly and glide on top of the frets. Instead of being like, it's more like a, instead of, but you can kind of play around with that, right? Then repeat that again, A minor, G to C. Third time. And after the third time, we're going to go to F major to G major. Alright, so you'll have your F major will be 10 on G and B, 8 on the high E. And I'm going to pick these and kind of give them like an arpeggiating type of thing. They don't really do that on the recording. I just think it sounds good. It kind of fills up the space if you're playing solo or like with a loop or something like I was doing the intro. Just hit 10, 10, 8. And then I just kind of pick G, E, B, G. Then go to G major. I'm going to hybrid pick all this, right? So when you do this, have your pick on the G string and your middle and ring finger on the B and E string. That G major will be 5 on D, 4 on G, 3 on B. Okay, same thing, just arpeggiate from B to G. Back to C major. Alright, so getting that to that little part, we'll go through it real quick. You have a... on your C, do that same lick from D to G. Okay, then do your little G7 thing. Okay, and then when you go back to C major, hit 1 on B, hit 2 on G, and then open G. Okay, and this will lead us into the solo. Alright, so that'll be all you need for the verse and the intro. So then we get into the solo part after we do that little walk down. Alright, so let's go over this first part here. So we're going to slide in from 3 to 5 on the low E string, and then get 3 on the A string. Hit 3 on A again. And after you hit 3 on A the second time, you're going to hit open D and hammer on to 2 on D. And then after you hammer on to 2 on D, take your finger off and mute the D string. Let the open G ring out. And then hit them together, D and G together, open. And hammer on to D on two. Okay, and then do that again. You're just gonna let those ring out. Then hit the G and G open. And let that D and G ring open, and then hit three on the A string, okay? Then we're gonna play an F major chord, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna have our thumb on one, mute out the A string, three on D, two on G, one on B, and we're gonna strum back at the bottom of the bridge, right? And with along with the tremolo, he might be using a whammy bar, but I really don't think so. I think he's just giving the chord some vibrato and strumming it back here. Okay, so just vibrato each note that's in the chord and just strum towards the back of the bridge, right? Okay, and after you do that little strum, we're gonna slide this double stop, two on G, one on B, and slide up to four and three, and back to one. Okay, and after you get back to one and two on G and B, keep your index finger down on the B string, and let this B string ring out the whole time. We'll hit the open G and the B string on one. And after you hit that B, you're gonna walk down, have D on the third fret with the open G to two on D with the open G, and let those open strings ring, okay? Okay, so we have. Okay, and then from here we're gonna go up to the seventh fret, bend it up a whole step. And then slide from 5 to 7 back to 5 on G. Okay, and after you slide 5 to 7 back to 5 on G, we're gonna go. So we'll have this thing, we'll slide in 5 to 7 on D. And we'll get 5 on G. And after you get 5 on G, slide in from 7 to 9 on G, get 8 on the B string, and let G and B ring out together, okay? And then hit them both together, the G and B on 9 and 8, after you get there, right? Then we're going to go G and B, a hybrid picket, pick on G, finger on B. And this is kind of like, it's kind of hard to teach what he's doing here. Basically slide a little bit with the bar on G and B with your index finger, and then you just kind of morph it into G and B with your ring and middle finger, right? I don't really know what fret to start on, I just kind of feel it, but you basically just have G and B. I guess I'll just tell you 7 and 6 on G and B, just to give you something to go off of. And then slide up to 14 on G and 13 on B. And from here, keep the same picking pattern, the hybrid picking pattern, and slide 14 G, 13 B up to 16 and 15. And slide that back and forth. A lot of this is going to be volume dependent, getting all this to ring out, right? After you slide that back, bar G and B on 10. Then we'll do this little double stop here. We'll have 7 on G, 8 on B. Hit that once, hit it again. And after you hit it again on G and B, let the G and B string ring out, but hammer on from 7 to 9 on G. And on the record, there's some kind of pedal steel effect that comes in on top of that, right? So you have okay, to seven, bend up a whole step, bend it down. Then land five on G. What we're going to do is cool little walk up. So we're going to slide in from 5 to 7 on D to 5 on G. I listened to this a whole bunch. I sat down, spent a couple hours just notating it all, making sure it was pretty, you know, dead on as I could get it. So slide in 5 to 7 on D, mute that out, and then go to 5 on G. Then we're going to pick, slide 7 to 9 on G, get 8 on B, let those ring out. Then we're going to slide up to 14 on G and 13 on B, letting the G and B ring out the whole time, right? And then from here, I'm not going to pick anything after I hit 14 and 13 on B. I'm just going to slide in with my ring finger and pinky into G and B on 17, right? So you have... Now, I think he may just have the B string on the record, but I think it sounds cooler just having G and B together. All right. And then we're going to walk it back, doing the same kind of double stops, right? This is basically C major. Okay. And then we have our little double stop here at a G major. And then C major again. Okay. So... So after you have 17 on G and B, go 16, 15 G and B to 12 and 13 G and B, right? Okay, and then we do our little slide in. Just slide in from like 5 to 9 on G and get 8 on the B string. Then we're back into our main part, A minor, G to C. Do the slide in, and this time we're going to go A minor, G to C, but we're going to go up an octave for the C. We'll go, all right, so we'll play the C major on 12 on G, 13 B, and 12 on E. Then do the slide in again, then F major to G major. Alright, so let's go ahead and play through the solo from beginning to end real slow. We'll start with the pickup that leads into it and then work our way through the entire thing. So that'll be the whole solo and then the outro that leads you back in to the little pre-chorus part. And that's all you need for the solo, right? So it's a great song. I think the only other thing is the ending, right? At the end, the rhythm part will go... Basically, it hangs on. It goes from G to C to D back to C, right? So you'd have like a... And it'll just go G, C, D, C. And on top of that will be the lead part. I'm just going to play it like this. And you can just hit the open G and B, then have 4 on G and 3 on B. Slide into 7 and 6 on G and B. And then your C major triad. G and B on 5 and 3 on the high E. Okay. And that'll be how the song ends. Okay, so that's everything. It's a really beautiful song. Such pretty guitar. Great guitar playing. It's the perfect example. It's the quintessential example of how triads can be utilized in a song for soloing and be done so to accompany a singer and just add some really beautiful kind of rhythm parts, you know, or lead parts over a really pretty rhythm section. It's just a really great example of sparse guitar playing using triads and feel and tone. And it's just a beautiful song. It's always meant a lot to me for a number of different reasons. If you haven't heard it, I'll put a link in the description so you can check it out. Like I said, man, I heard this in the Tin Cup movie. I think it was also in Fools Rush In with Matthew Perry, who just died recently. But it's a great song, and I hope you enjoy it. Practice slow. Have fun. See you next time.